I'm going to shoot this little video. It's kind of just a still video of the tractor as the introduction to part 9. Last week I had torn apart the steering column off of it and couldn't find the clutches, and kind of thought maybe the clutches didn't exist. But I have, after posting the video, I've kind of been informed by one of my viewers that the clutches are buried further into the transmission. So that part will be coming. I have filmed, prior to me finding that out, I had filmed some footage of me removing the brakes and stuff. So I am going to throw that up here as part 9 to the video. I've got some stuff going on, dental work that I have to have done, and some other things going on that's probably not going to let me pull the transmission apart to find that clutch pack this week. So this is what I'm going to throw up. Again, the video had been shot before I found out that the clutch packs for the TA are buried further into the transmission. So that will be coming. As you can probably see from the shot, I have the standoff of the front of the tractor, and the front of the transmission housing is actually being supported by the gantry crane. I've got to get a stand underneath the rear part of the transmission, so when I pull the front half off, I've got support under it. So that is coming, but again, I've got this footage for the brakes that I pulled apart off of there, and I'm gonna throw that up and throw up some footage of me prepping the area for taking this transmission apart. So here it is, part 9. Okay, so we're back on the tractor. I'm just pulling the brake covers off and finding out what's going on inside of them. Never had them off before. Again, I'm gonna have to get a screwdriver and get the dirt off around that bolt. The other reason I'm doing this is, well, I'm doing it for a couple of reasons. I need to get these plates cleaned up. Probably the best way to do it is put it in a bead blaster. But I want to see what the hydraulics look like on this thing, because I want to get all of that old fluid out of the system. And part of the system being the brakes. So the brake cylinders, I'm going to need to get the fluid out of that. Let me grab an impact and it'll be a lot quicker. Let me bring that. I'm gonna say those two broken discs probably went in there. And then this plate was up against it. And the whole thing, would have collapsed against that. Or, let me put this on a bench and we'll take it over there and pull it apart. Okay, here it is on the bench, and a lot of dirt in these things. Not really sure what those things are for.
These adjusting tubes are not really adjusters per se. They push the primary plate back after the brakes have been applied and released. So they don't really adjust, they push it back.
I think what I'm going to do is put this in the bead blaster. Not going to blast the inside logically, but I want to get all of this stuff off of the outside, and then maybe take it over to the parts washer and clean out the inside. I'll try and get most of this stuff off of it. But it's kind of a greasy, kind of that dry, greasy stuff. Yeah, let me do that. Just wanted to give you a shot of this. I just took it over the bead blaster and went over it, and it came out pretty good. It'd be a lot better for paint. The ridges in there will be more detailed. Sure, a lot less dirt on it. But anyways, I just wanted to give you a shot of it before I put it in the parts washer to clean the inside. Off camera, I just kind of got this pry bar stuck behind there and realized that this thing was loose, that apparently it comes off of there. So what I'm going to do is disconnect the brake line, hydraulic line, and see if this thing comes off as a unit. Now I got to tell you, I do have a manual on this thing, and I could go and consult that and see what it does, but sometimes it's just as easy to what I was going to say, sometimes just as easy to just kind of take it apart. What kind of baffled me was there was absolutely no oil. No oil residue in that line at all. It's almost like that brake wasn't the brake wasn't getting any fluid into it. Okay, I don't know whether it's stuck on there or there's something that's holding it. So let me investigate it a little bit more and I'll bring it back. I'm going to leave the camera rolling. What I did is I just worked it a little bit with a screwdriver. There's like gaskets or shims in there. And I think it was just kind of stuck. It's also kind of a tight fit. There's a lot of slop in that bearing. I don't know whether... that's supposed to be like that or not. They just keep coming. Bring you over here. I just wanted to show you. I laid that brake thing there, and it's actually leaking some fluid. So there was some fluid getting into it, but didn't look right. You know, didn't look like there was a lot of fluid in it. And I'm perplexed as to how this thing works. It's a concealed unit. I'll have to take a look at it. I'll show it to you when I'm going to bring it, put it up on a bench, and I'll show it to you how it works. It either compresses that shaft, or maybe there's a plate that pivots out to, I'm going to say that's probably what it is, or those other brake plates wouldn't be in here. It has to push a plate out to get it to work, but I'll put it up on a bench and I'll show it to you. Okay, I'm not sure if you're going to be able to see this. I told you I'd show it to you, but if I push on this, it moves. So apparently what it does, pressurizes the chamber behind this plate, and this whole plate pushes out against the brake pads. kind of a concealed, ingenious way of doing the brakes. I don't really want to take it apart, that part apart, because I've got to assume there's a lot of seals in there to keep that fluid from coming out around here. So I'm going to leave it. If it isn't broke, don't fix it. It's not like the brakes aren't easy enough to get to. If it does start leaking in some point in the future, I can always just pull that housing off and repair the brakes internally anyways. But for now, I'm going to leave the internals of that hydraulic system alone. I washed my hands, but I couldn't. Was going to go home, but I just couldn't leave it alone. Had to see what was under here. I know what it is, just gears. But wanted to kind of see the condition of them. They weren't that loose. I loosened them up off camera. More of that oil. That oil. See that gray stuff? Still kind of baffled where that's coming from. Yours are good. They're not nicked. Okay, enough for tonight, I'll bring you back. One of the things that I had to do here before I go much farther is do a little housekeeping. I had some of these parts, the oil galley cover for the pump, the hydraulic pump, I had laying down here on this cardboard, and parts and pieces laying around, so I've kind of organized it, put it over here on the cardboard. I had actually had this shelf built kind of for the parts, and I would have had to reorganize it to get these parts in there, but for now they're good enough down there on the floor laying on the cardboard. The one thing that I do need to do is I need to get the steering column and tank moved out of the way in preparation for taking that front housing and the transmission off. I think what I'm going to do is just move it further up towards the front wheel and put it up there. I've kind of got the the front of the tank resting on a little stool. It's actually a stool for a potter's wheel that I've got to sell, but it's not mine. It belongs to somebody, and I just told them I'd sell it, and I haven't even listed had it for months and haven't even listed it yet, but I got to get that out of the way. So I'm going to just bring the tank and steering column assembly up and put it up in here and get preparations. I've got to once I get that up in the air, I've got to get a stand underneath that back half of the axle transmission housing, because this stand will be coming off and be coming up so that I can take the front transmission housing off. So all things that have got to be done, but I'll bring you back. Just wanted to show you what I did. I'm by myself, so I didn't want that tank tipping. I took this little block and tackle, rope block and tackle that I have on my jib crane, and just strapped the top of the tank up to the strap, and so that it would support the front of the tank, keep it from tipping down and leaking that fuel out. But I've got it over here in the front. I made a little stand just to kind of support the front of the tank so that I could get that stool out of there. But that's over there now, and I can concentrate on getting stuff for this. I'm gonna have to use a jack stand or try and figure out what I'm gonna do to support the that transmission while I take the front of the transmission, the front of the differential housing, when I take that front off. So I'll bring you back for that. I've got the front of the transmission supported by the Ganter crane. Just going to be pulling off of this stand. What I'm probably going to do is get a tap and just clean them threads out with that, but I'll bring it back. I was going to support the front of that differential housing, transmission housing, the forward part of the rear half of it. I was going to support it with a jack stand, but the jack stand's not really tall enough, so let me figure out what I can get for that. I told you I was going to run a tap in there. What I'm probably going to do is use the step bolt on. I didn't look like it was in that housing. I'll probably use the step bolts and get the engine hoist under the back side of it, leave the Ganter crane on the front side, engine hoist on the back side of it with a sling, and use that to pull it out. But I'll bring it back.